about fundamental of nursing. So in this subject, I am going to discuss about therapeutic nursing care for GNM first year students. I am going to discuss this subject. And in therapeutic nursing care, as a nurse, how she is going to give the care to the patient. So now I am going to discuss about who is the patient who is having fluid and electrolyte imbalance. So in that already I have discussed fluid, body fluid imbalance about the topic and electrolytes also. In electrolyte imbalance, and if it is imbalance in the patient, what will happen? So this calcium also one part of the electrolyte. So if the calcium levels are increasing in the body, what will happen? So what type of problems the patient can face through this problem? So that thing now I am going to explain. First thing is calcium. So it is part of the electrolytes, and due to increase in the amount of calcium in the human body, there is a chance to get due to increase in the amount of calcium in the human body, and it is known as hypercalcemia. So hypercalcemia. And next thing is, what is the normal value of calcium? 8.5 to 10.3 mg per liter. So if it is above 10.3, that is known as hypercalcemia. So by name itself, you can understand that is the increasing the level of calcium in the human body. And we will see what are the risk factors for this hypercalcemia. First one is prolonged immobilization. So if the patient is not able to mobilize himself, so if the patient is not able to walk himself, so due to prolong this immobilization, there it is also one type of risk factor to lead the hypercalcemia. So prolonged immobilization of the patient. And next thing is hyperparathyroidism. So by name itself you can understand that is hyper. So we are seeing hypocalcemia, hypoparathyroidism. So it is also hypercalcemia, and the risk factor also hyperparathyroidism. And next one is malignancy of the bone. So the bone is malignancy of the bone. And next one is Paget's disease. So what is meant by this disease? This is bone include bone pain and joint pain. So this problem can caused by now being squashed or damaged. So this is the meaning of Paget's disease. So it is nothing but there is the bone include bone pain or joint pain problems. This is caused by now being squashed or damaged. So this is the risk factors we can see in hypercalcemia. So next thing is clinical manifestation. So which type of clinical manifestations may be present in this condition? Lethargy. So there is inactivity-ness in the patient. So that is the meaning of lethargy. And next one is weakness and restlessness. So these things also may be present in the patient. Anorexia. The patient may not feel to eat. And next one is nausea, vomiting. So nausea and vomiting also. So constipation. So the patient may have constipation. And next one is urinary calculi. So there is a formation of calculi in the kidney. And next thing is cardia dysrhythmia. So there is a irregular heartbeat. And next one is depressed deep tendon reflex. So there is a chance to get depressed deep tendon reflexes. So these are the clinical manifestations we can see in hypercalcemia condition. So one more time I will read it. First one is lethargy may be present in the patient. And next one is weakness or restlessness. And next one is anorexia, nausea, vomiting. And next one is confused constipation. And next one is urinary calculi and cardiac dysrhythmias. And next one is depressed deep tendon reflexes. So these are the clinical manifestations we can see in hypercalcemia. condition. So at such type of condition patient as well as how she is going to take care the patient in the hospital, that thing now I will explain. So dear students, we are discussing about hyperthalassemia. So we completed the laboratory findings. Next, as well as how she is going to take care the patient in the hospital. That thing now we will see in nursing intervention. So there is an increased so the nurse, as a nurse, she has to tell the patient to increase the client movement and exercises. So the nurse has to tell the patient to do the exercise and increase his activities, increase his movements in the body. So that thing, as a nurse, she has to explain to the patient. And next one is encourage about oral fluid. So as a nurse, she has to encourage the patient to take more oral fluids. And next one is encourage ingestion of fiber diet to prevent constipation. So tell the patient to prevent that constipation to take such type of fiber diet. So that thing as a nurse, she has to explain to the patient and she should encourage the client to take fiber diet. And next thing is she has to monitor the vitals of the patient, especially this thing. And she should maintain the vitals, monitor the vitals. If anything abnormal, she should see that whether it is any abnormalities present or not. And next thing is she has to observe the client condition. She should assess the clinical manifestation of the patient. And according to the physician order for this condition, which type of medicine can give. So according to the physician order, the nurse has to administer the medication. It may be orally or may be intravenously. So depend on the patient and depend on the physician order, the nurse has to administer the medication. So it may be orally or it may be intravenously. And next thing is, as a nurse, the patient may have fear and anxiety regarding this condition. So to prevent that fear and anxiety, as a nurse, she has to provide health education regarding the nature of illness to the patient and their family members. For what? To prevent that fear and anxiety. And she should show the pictures also. And next thing is, she has to provide psychological support for the patient. And she should tell the patient how to take the medicine and how to take the proper diet, and which is, and next thing is, she should tell the patient the calcium restricted diet, that diet that patient has to take. So whenever the patient is taking the diet, low calcium diet the patient has to take, because there is a increase in the calcium levels in the body. So the patient cannot take the high calcium diet. So the patient has to take low calcium diet. So which food is contains low calcium, which fruits, juices, that all those things as a nurse she has to explain to the patient and their family members also. So these things we can see in nursing intervention. So in nursing intervention, as a nurse she has to check the serum calcium levels in between. So according to the physician order, when she is going to administer the medication by orally or intravenously, after administering that medication, she has to observe the calcium levels, whether it is decreased or not. Then she has to check for, she has to take the ECG also. So whether there is the his cardio function. So to identify that those things, the nurse has to do these things in between also. So these things we can see in nursing intervention. So completed this hyperthalassemia topic. So till now whatever I have discussed, that thing one more time I will explain. So first we have seen that is what is meant by hyperthalassemia and how it is known as hyperthalassemia. And the next thing is what are the risk factors are present in this condition. And next one is clinical manifestation. Who is having hyperthalassemia, such type of patient, which type of clinical manifestations may be present. So next thing is laboratory findings. In laboratory findings, as nursing. Next thing is as a nurse, how she is going to give the care to the patient in the hospital, and how she is going to encourage the client how to take the diet and which type of diet the patient has to take. That thing the nurse we have seen in nursing intervention, and about health education, everything we have seen in nursing intervention. So completed this topic. Thank you.
Thank you.